stone, and I fell heavy into your arms. These days of dust, I wish we'd known, will blow away with this new sun. But
first had the meeting with our manager and said that we were booking the UK tour for after the album had come out, and the plan was to maybe try and play at Shepherd's Bush Empire. We were just like, are you sure? You know, all of us had doubts about it. I've been away for a long time because we were touring in Europe and then we did India and then we came back to London, and things had changed slightly. Like, we noticed, having been away for a few months, that things had gone up a gear, which is intimidating, but you know, good.
That was great, I love that gig.
That was really fun.
That was awesome.
Feeling good?
What's going on?
Cause if you love me the way you say you do, I know I could always be happy with you. I'm a believer. I'm no deceiver.
The Wedding Bands is the band I wish I was in. I wish it was that was that, and then Mumford & Sons is a side project. And it's just like, got to get some of the light-hearted stuff off our chest. We had Adam Stockdale playing Lap Steel. He's sick. He pretty much like walked out of a 70s prog rock band. Callum Lindsay, who's a Scottish fiddle player, amazing. He's an old friend. And we had Dev and Nick, who play horns with us and have been playing or touring with us for a lot of this year. Nick comes from a jazz background, no one's perfect. And then we had Jesse Quinn playing drums, who's an old friend, and we played at his wedding actually, so that ties it in. We've done three weddings, yeah. He's going to be touring with his band with us in the States as well, which would be really nice. Maybe do some wedding stuff out there. Yeah, we'll see. Oi oi. Good as I nail that one. Yeah? Not too boring? Am I boring you?
Say, oh, if you love me the way you say you do, I know I could always be happy with you. I'm a believer. I'm no deceiver.
A lot of the time it feels like, yeah, music is some sort of excuse to be a human. It's kind of like people need that excuse to go and put their arms in the air and sing their hearts out.
It's so much fun to play when the crowd gives, you've got to match it. And it makes for a better gig. And for us and for them, you get sweat on and it just gets hairy and dirty. And just feels really like just electric. It's amazing.
It's fun to go to Australia and play some gigs because they played us on the radio and stuff, but it's nice to actually go there and play gigs, and we'd never experienced that reception before.
I've nowhere to stand, but now nowhere to hide.
Welcome back to Australia, gentlemen.
Thank you very much.
Why do you think you've connected so well with Aussies?
I know what I've seen. I went out back and I got my gun. I said, you haven't met me. I am the only son.
Oh, wow.
Otto?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, if you just want to take a step back for a sec. So no kisses, unfortunately, no, they will bite you. I know.
Eric Clapton?
Just quickly.
Mikhail Gorbachev?
Ted Turner, John, Jane Fonda? Nice.
Marilyn Manson?
Ah, whoa.
Whoa. The Pope.
He's got the Pope there, and we zoom right here. We've got the dough.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Hello.
Bye
bye.
Bye
bye. Bye bye. Bye bye.
Fuck off.
Just playing to people is just a great way to meet people and to see the world. It's a great world to see.
Every time we book a tour, we're like, yes, look at all those gigs. Those gigs we get to play.
Today is a big day. We're on our way in, having a pretty standard bit of tour breakfast. And yeah, we're heading into the site and we're gonna do one of the biggest shows we've ever done, which is pretty exciting.
Why don't you welcome the tent, Mumford and Sons.
Last couple of weeks have been very special, actually. Every show has been a highlight, and like just touring this country is so different. And I think people don't quite understand, because it's so vast and you're doing a flight and you feel like every city you go to is a real arrival and you get your teeth into it. It's just been like a real journey. We've met some really interesting people.
We try quite hard to be more of an inclusive band than a kind of a band that's just there to be seen. We're very dependent on the crowd, and I think we make that quite clear to them, whether we say it or whether we mean it, you know, from the stage. People notice that when they give us something, we're able to give more back. I guess in a world where those kind of personal engagements are becoming less and less common, I suppose, you know. So we enjoy that part of what we do.
Tremble for yourself, my man. You know that you have seen this all before. Tremble, little lion man. You'll never settle any of your scores. Your grace is wasted in your face. Your boldness stands alone among the wreck. Now learn from your mother, or I'll spend your days biting your own neck. But it was not your fault but mine, and it was your heart on the line. I really fucked it up this time, didn't I, my dear? Didn't I, my dear?
Songs are so weird because you write them in the most private moments and then they become the most public thing you could do with the personal creation you have. It's pretty strange, but it's also amazing. Sometimes it's just overwhelming hearing how much people are reacting to it. That's a nice thing, that's a good thing, I think.
Game off. Yep.
Lovely. Cheers, guys. Have a brilliant weekend.
Cheers.
What's your highlight so far?
My highlight of the festival so far.
So many festivals around Britain, but Glastonbury just has. Like, it seems to have everything from across, like, the best of everything. Because it's like, I suppose it's a festival that's kind of embedded itself into British culture quite a lot. People are quite proud of Glastonbury. It's one of those. I don't know if they feel the same about that many other ones. It's not something we've ever really had ambition for, which is a bit like, so it wasn't a sort of like, yes, we've finally done it. But it's still, it is pretty overwhelming, very blessed to have that experience. It is a special one to nail. You've got to nail Glastonbury.
At the moment, it seems like we're all really comfortable with each other. And that's a good thing, because we're spending a lot of time together at the moment. Like, yeah, in each other's pockets non-stop, sharing hotel rooms and sleeping about 2 foot away from each other on a bus every night. And going through like tiredness together and elation together and sickness together, you know. I think we're all going through this with our eyes open and our feet on the ground, which is nice. And I think if it was any different, we'd let each other know.
Get over your hill and see what you find there.